To taurine or not to taurine? That's the question. Taurine is an ingredient in some so-called energy drinks, which some people consume to improve physical performance, although there is little evidence that taurine per se exerts any beneficial effects in healthy individuals or animals without taurine depletion. But that was written before this seminal study, published in one of the most prestigious scientific journals, showing that taurine supplementation, starting in middle age, can significantly improve the health span and lifespan of a number of different animals. Now, not all animal studies have shown benefit. Lifelong taurine supplementation induced retardation of learning in mice, for example, and low doses of taurine significantly enhanced lung tumor growth in mice, which led the authors to suggest that lung cancer patients may want to stay away from drinks with taurine. You probably wouldn't want to consume too much taurine if you have kidney failure either, since taurine levels are normally regulated by our kidneys. The acute symptoms of taurine overload, mainly dizziness, were relatively mild and rapidly disappeared after stopping taurine, but researchers suggest that there should be warning-type labels on beverages containing taurine to caution patients with kidney failure from drinking them. Similarly, patients who have bleeding disorders may not want to take taurine, since it might thin our blood. Psoriasis patients may also want to steer clear, as taurine evidently causes a predictable, intense itching response that can last a day or two, making skin lesions worse. It even caused the same reaction in psoriasis patients in remission. Pregnant and lactating women are pretty much encouraged to stay away from any and all supplements not specifically prescribed for pregnancy. Similarly, individuals with specific health conditions such as bipolar disorder, epilepsy, or kidney problems may want to be cautious. The only bipolar problem I could find were a few case reports of mania blamed on Red Bull. This guy drank 20 cans of Red Bull. That would make me manic too. But of course, Red Bull is more than just taurine. Caffeine alone may do it. The epilepsy concern may have to do with taurine inhibiting detoxifying enzymes in the liver that are responsible for breaking down many commonly used drugs, including anti-seizure drugs. It could also be because of adverse reactions reported by some patients with epilepsy who took 1.5 grams a day, including nausea, headache, dizziness, nosebleed, and mild walking disturbances. But the epilepsy seemed incidental. That may just be what sometimes you see at higher doses. Potential side effects of excess consumption of taurine supplements beyond recommended doses includes gastrointestinal disturbances such as nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, neurological symptoms like the dizziness, tremors, and headaches. What are the recommended doses? A proposed tolerated upper safety limit based on human clinical trials is up to 3 grams a day, but the longest trial at that dose was only up to 4 months. In my last video, I talked about a parallel with another conditionally non-essential amino acid called arginine that similarly looked good in short-term trials, but by 6 months appeared to be killing people. Oopsie! So the study was shut down. So who knows if the supposed safe level of 3 grams a day is actually safe? The dose used in that promising animal study might be equivalent to dosing people with even more than that, and higher doses aren't necessarily better. In this study on inflammation and oxidative stress, the lower doses, 3 grams or less, appeared to work better. The thought is that high doses of taurine could downregulate our own synthesis of taurine. Why would that be a problem? Well, our body makes taurine from another amino acid called cysteine. So if we're no longer churning out taurine, that may cause our levels of cysteine to build up. At least that's what happens in mice. And that might be bad, because chronically high levels of cysteine have been closely associated with a whole list of disease states, including rheumatoid arthritis, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, lupus, cardiovascular disease, adverse pregnancy outcomes. On the other hand, taurine may inhibit our absorption of another amino acid called methionine, since taurine and methionine share the same absorption transporter through our intestinal lining. That would be presumed to be a good thing, since lowering methionine intake is considered a feasible strategy against chronic and aging-related diseases, as I discussed in How Not to Age. And finally, the animal study didn't address the impact of taurine dietary supplementation on the gut microbiome, which I'll cover next.